Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we'll interpret differences in shape, center and spread in the context of the data sets, accounting for possible effects of extreme data points, that is outliers. Now, in our earlier session, we had discussed about the shape of distribution. We know about various measures of central tendency, measures of spread and outliers. First of all, let us recall center. Now, measure of center refers to the measure used to describe the most typical value in the data set. This value represents the whole data. And most common measure of center is mean and median. Now let us discuss about spread. Now spread of distribution refers to the variability of data. If the data cluster around the central value, then the spread is smaller. The farther the observations fall from the center, the greater the variability or spread of the data. And we use range, interquartile range and standard deviation as measures of spread. Now the shape of distribution is described by symmetry. Number of peaks and skewness. Now let us discuss outliers. Sometimes distributions are characterized by extreme values that differ greatly from the other observations. And these extreme values in the distribution are called outliers. These values are either very large or very small from all other values in the data set. As a rule, the value is considered as an outlier if it is at least 1.5 times interquartile range below the lower quartile, or at least 1.5 times interquartile range above the upper quartile. That is, the value is considered to be an outlier if it lies outside the specific range, that is Q1 minus 1.5 into interquartile range, and Q3 plus 1.5 into interquartile range. Now, in histograms, the bar of the outlier will be far away from the other bars in the display. Now, when we compare two data sets, one should discuss each characteristic of the data, that is center, spread, shape and outlier. Now, let us discuss an example. To study black bear population, the wildlife department measured the length of 143 bears. The following dot plots show the distribution of lengths of male and female bears. And we have to compare the two distributions. Now we are given one dot plot showing the lengths of 100 male bears and other showing lengths of 43 female bears. First we see the shape of distribution. Now the first distribution is very slightly skewed to the left, but more or less it is symmetrical. But the second distribution is skewed to the left, now here with this free run curve you can see that this distribution is skewed to the left. Now let us see the center. Now here the length of male ears is concentrated between 58 and 64. If we see its median, then it will be around 59. So its center is around 59. Thus average length of male ear is around 59 inches. Now in second distribution we see that most data, that is most of the data, is concentrated between 58 and 62 and median is around 59. So average length of female ear is around 59 inches. Now let us discuss spread of the distribution. Now in distribution 1 we can see that data is moving farther from center and is spread. But in second distribution the data is clustered around the center and is less spread. So standard deviation in male data set will be greater than female data set. So data is more spread in male distribution set . Now let us discuss outliers. Now, in first distribution, there are no outliers because there is no value which is extreme from all other values. But in second distribution, we can see that 89, that is the value 89, is lying very far away from all other values in the data set. So 89 is an extreme value, that is it is an outlier. Thus we can see that there is a lot of variation in the length of male ears than that of female ears, and average length of male ear is equal to average length of female ear. So in this session we have discussed how to compare the two distributions using shape, spread, center and outliers. And this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.